I'm joined here by Kushager Krishnater, who drew against Farrukh Amonatov. Kushager, how was the game?
Yeah, the game went pretty well. It was started with Steinitz Stafford, where he took on c6 very early. This line is considered harmless usually, but okay, I was out of my book after he took on d4 with the knight. Later on, I didn't like his plan. He tried to do some rash attack, but I got a comfortable position. I think this is the first critical moment here. Now, he was planning to
play... You are black.
Yeah.
Yes.
He was planning to play bishop h6 here, but I have a very good idea with knight c4, b into c4, queen b4, and I thought, okay, he could try this, but I have this. And I thought, okay, after this, I mean, I think this is not working, so this should be winning for black. So he realized it a bit later and he didn't play this, of course.
So bishop h6 was not working, yeah, it was, which okay. Meant that you had more attacking chances.
Yeah, I mean, it was his initial idea, but it was not working because of tactical reasons. So he had to play rook f1, which I missed, but okay, it's not that strong. Queen b4, he played knight b1. Now again, after a5, I have a very good position. He can't take on b4 because I've aimed to b4 and it's completely better. He played bishop h6. Now again, this position is interesting. I could have tried knight c4, but okay, I was not sure about the position after queen g5, bishop b2 check, king b1. So I thought, okay, after this, my position is completely better. He played this. Okay, I exchanged this and okay, here I had some chances for c4, but I was unsure whether he could try f4, knight g4 and f4 bishop h6. Yeah, I considered bishop h6 as the main option, but okay, after bishop d2, knight g4, b into c4, it was better, but I thought, okay, it's unnecessary to give up on. So I played rook a2, he played f4. I played bishop h6. In this position, it is important not to exchange the bishops because his position is quite passive and he doesn't have any good squares for his pieces. He played bishop d2, I played knight g4 and knight c3. Okay, now here we repeated moves with rook a3 and rook a3, knight b1, rook a2. I thought that okay, after rook a8 I'm slightly better, but Indian doesn't accept that. He says that I'm completely winning. But okay, after this, we agreed a draw.
So how are you completely winning after rook a8?
I mean, white's pieces are paralyzed. I have bishop g7, bishop d4, and after this, he doesn't have any good plan. I mean, okay, I can play rook e8 at some point, and his pieces do not have good squares. That's the main reason. And I have some ideas with this as well, where his king is slightly awkward.
Well, in general, your bishops are very strong.
Yeah.
Right, so... happy with this result or
okay,
a little
kind
bit
of,
sad?
Yes. I'm happy. I mean, with black and a draw against 2600, it's a very good result.
Is this one of your first draws against a 2600 opponent?
Yeah. Okay, it's not the first draw. It's my first
game.
Match against
that. Oh, okay.
I've never played anyone higher than 2470 in a classical game, of course.
So this tournament is going to be a very interesting one for you. Kushager, which grade are you in?
Okay, I have just completed my 10th currently, and I'm.
And you live in Mumbai?
Yeah, Thane.
And whom do you learn chess from?
Okay, Akash Thakur.
And what is your aim like now that you are in 10th? Are you going to focus on your education after this or on chess?
Okay, this year I'm planning to focus on chess and hopefully I become a IM like you. Okay, after that I have not decided what to do.
I became at 24. I think you're going to do it in maybe before you turn 16. Well, wish you all the best and many more opponents about 2470 whom you can beat here.
Yeah, thank you.
So good luck.
Yeah.